Hello, I am Philippe Kekut. I'm working at a laboratory called LATMOS, working on the atmosphere. And myself, I will present a new instrument that has been developed that is called LIDAR. And this instrument is used for probing the atmosphere and measure the vertical profile of different component of the atmosphere with light. Myself, I will present, you see on the outline, how we measure the atmosphere before the LIDAR to understand the value of this new instrument. I will also talk about the composition of the atmosphere because, of course, for the students, we don't see and the atmosphere, so we may think atmosphere is empty, and so we have to realize that it is full of molecules and particles. Then I will talk about the light, which is a concept that is required to understand the LIDAR, and then talk specifically how the LIDAR is working and the use of the LIDAR. So one of the issues with the LIDAR is that mainly the polar zone are difficult to date because of the conditions, the fact that it's far, it is cold, and so this type of instrument is very innovative and interesting because we can measure from a distance. And so we call that type of instruments remote sensing instruments. Those are instruments that are very useful now for probing difficult areas like the poles. So, as I said, I will talk about the different methods that have been used in the past. That include the bands, but also the rockets that are very comparable with the range we cover with LIDAR. And so this is also interesting because it is related with the history. Then I will talk more specifically about the interaction of light with the atmosphere. And so trying to explain these interactions, we'll see some picture that illustrates why the sky is blue, why clouds are white, and then we understood how the laser we are using for the instruments interact with the atmosphere. Then, we will explain more specifically how it's made the LIDAR, and of course the main part of the LIDAR is the laser, so we have to explain what is a laser. And we collect the signal using a telescope. So we will also explain how we do that and how is made this type of instrument. We will explain also one concept that is important to understand how LIDAR is working, is the concept of the radar. The fact we send a pulse, and with that pulse, we can deduce the altitude where interactions occurs. And so this is really make the LIDAR very, very competitive instruments compared with passive instruments that are not could provide the information on the vertical. So then we will compare with the radar that children most of the time know a little bit to explain the LIDAR. And of course, we will talk about the applications because all those LIDAR are working at ground with different types, measuring different parameters. And then I will show a film, a movie, that allow to see how in practical this instrument is working and look like when it's in operation. But also, I will also talk about the instruments we put in space. We have some of them our imagination at that time. And so it's very important for people to understand that Star Wars start for a long time for us, and laser on space, probably the atmosphere above our head for a long time. And we collect information since a long time that is very useful for clouds and particles like volcanic particles. So this and the presentations with, of course, at the end, the exercise count for the children to see how they understood the LiDAR and the interactions of the light with the atmosphere. Okay, tune for the next presentations.